Are you looking to sell your home in the near future, but you're unsure of what to focus on without wasting your time and money? We're gonna go over that in this video. And stick around to the end where I will tell you the one thing to get you the most return on your investment back. So stay tuned. Hey there, folks. It's your favorite Washington State broker realtor, Katrina Halterman, bringing you all the tips and tricks you need to get your home ready to sell. And I'm also going to tell you what to focus on and what to not focus on so you're not wasting your time and money. So here's a little bit about my background. I've actually gone to school and earned a degree in interior design and have also worked in an interior design agency before I became an agent, which will be helpful in today's video. Today, I'm channeling my interior design background and providing you with easy steps that will make your home shine like never before, and also giving you tips on what to do and not to do. So let's dive right in and make this process fun, exciting, and oh so informative. First things first, let's change our perspective. Put on your bias glasses and look at the house with fresh eyes. Notice any glaring issues or maintenance tasks that have been put off for far too long. You may have lived there for some time and have learned to live with those things. But remember, buyers will respond to what they see, so fix those leaky faucets, dusty vents, and nail pops. Some buyers pay attention to the small things because in their minds, if the seller didn't take care of the small thing, what big thing did they not take care of? And when you're doing this, you gotta remember that a home inspector and appraiser will look at this home as well. So let's transform your home from a living condition to a showing condition. Naturally, we human beings are conditioned to look for what's wrong with a house. And buyers start to add up these costs in their heads as they walk around the home. So putting your home in the best possible light is key. You only have one chance to make a good first impression. Now, let's talk about curb appeal. The first time a potential buyer sees your home is online through the photos. And before they even click on anything, there's usually a main photo that is showcased of the exterior of the home, usually the front. So the main photo is what attracts the potential buyer to click on the listing to learn more about the property and see more photos. Then these bulk of photos are actually your first showing. These photos will be what entices someone to want to book a showing to see the property in person. And then you also have to think about the moment a buyer pulls up to the home. I've actually been in a situation where I showed a home and before we even entered the house, my buyer told me right off the bat that she just knew this home wasn't for her. She says she just had a feeling, and that's what it is. For many people, buying a home is a very emotional journey, so you have to focus on how it looks. You have to make your front door and entry area irresistible. This will set a tone for the rest of the house. Give your house a good pressure wash to eliminate any mildew and dirt. Don't forget to freshen up that front door with a new coat of paint. Windex those windows so they're nice and shiny. Trim those bushes and make sure they're not overpowering your home. And please don't forget to mow the lawn and mulch those flower beds. Oh, and that front doormat, if it has seen better days, it's time to invest in a new one. Northwest roofs really take a beating. It's months of constant moisture, which means plenty of opportunity for moss and fungus to take hold. But when it comes to your roof, you don't ever want to pressure wash it because it's actually really hard on the shingles. You want to go ahead and soft wash your roof if necessary, which will kill any moss, dirt, and grime while restoring your roof to its natural color. But on the other hand, if your roof is caving in, don't just patch your roof, fix it properly if it's really necessary. According to the NAR Remodeling Impact Report, a home seller can get 100% of their money back from a new roof. That's huge! So if your home needs it and you have the budget for it, it might be a good idea to replace that roof altogether. First impressions are the lasting ones, so make it a good one. All right. Now let's tackle the senses. The smell is a powerful thing, my friends, and smell is the quickest way to tap into someone's emotions. So let's make sure your home smells fresh and clean. Address any odors from pets, diapers, or trash. Open those windows and let some fresh air in. But be careful not to overdo it with the fresheners. We don't want to give the impression that you're hiding something. And when your home is live on the market, if you have a showing coming up within the hour, don't cook anything with a strong smell. I've been in both situations where the air freshener was too strong, and also in the situation where the smell of the seller's dinner was still lingering in the air, and in both scenarios, my buyers could not wait to get out there fast enough. It's just not pleasant, so be very cognizant of that stuff. And speaking of impressions, let's brighten up your home. Brighter homes feel happier and are more inviting, and that's exactly what we want to convey to potential buyers. Consider painting any dark walls in a lighter or neutral color. Keep the lights on and blinds open during showings, and if you have a dark curtain, think about swapping that out for a lighter one. Consider the light bulbs. Swap out the cool tone light bulbs for a warm tone light bulb. Cool tone light bulbs give the impression of a colder, unwelcoming environment. You want your home to be warm and pleasant to be in. The sale happens in the buyer's mind when they can picture themselves living in the home. So you have to make it as light, airy, warm, and inviting as possible. Now, let's address those odd noises that can distract buyers. Squeaky doors and rattling drawers are a big no-no. Lubricate and silence those noises. Tighten up loose screws and make your home a peaceful oasis. Next, let's talk about decluttering. This is an incredibly important step, yet can cost little or nothing. It just takes a little time and elbow grease. Simplify and create open spaces that buyers can envision as their own. Clear off those countertops, clean the windows, touch up the baseboards, and organize your closet. Ask yourself, do I really need all this stuff? Donate what you don't need. And remember, open space sells. When the home is cluttered with stuff, it's very hard for a potential buyer to envision their things in that space, which will stop a buyer cold. Another rule of thumb is anything that is less than 6 inches, put away. You don't want to make it easier for someone to take when you start having showings in your home. And also, if you have any prescription medicine, put those away as well. Buyers will open drawers and closets to see if their things fit in those areas. So put away those extra coats in the closet. Take away those dishes that you don't use. Your goal is to open the space up as much as you can. And here's a tough one, but trust me, it's worth it. Depersonalize your home. Take down those family pictures, religious items, collectibles, and knickknacks. We want buyers to see themselves in your home, not invading someone else's personal space. Start packing up those personal items and get ready for your next adventure. I mean, you're gonna be moving anyway, right? So get some boxes, pack those things away, store them in a storage unit or the garage. Now, let's talk about home improvements. If your home hasn't been updated in 20 years, consider upgrading it to the modern standards. Yes, spending a little money on certain upgrades can actually increase your home's value. Focus on areas like the kitchen, bathroom, flooring, and the hardware. Updating these areas can save you from potential buyers who start calculating the cost in their head. Remember, a small investment now can save you from a price reduction later. A few thousand dollars now can save you from having to make tens of thousands of dollars in price reductions later on. Now, what you want to do is avoid partial fixes. If something needs fixing, do the whole thing or not at all. Buyers don't want to see unfinished projects It just gives a bad impression, and they may wonder what other shortcuts were taken. So no half fixes. And it's the same thing when updating the kitchen and the bathrooms. If you're considering renovating your house and thinking of focusing on just one area, remember this. Don't redo the kitchen if you have old bathrooms, and don't remodel the bathrooms if you have old kitchen. It's all or nothing. Doing a complete renovation will never bring back all of your money, let alone make a profit. Our goal is to maximize your house's value without wasting money on unnecessary redesigns. Before you even think about putting your house on the market, start interviewing agents early. Don't settle for just anyone. Look for an agent with a proven track record of success and a marketing strategy that will blow your socks off. You want someone who will expose your home to the widest possible audience and negotiate the best deal on your behalf. For example, in my listing strategy, which includes professional photography, videography, drone shots, flyers, and paid advertising, I also offer to have my boots on the ground, which means door knocking the neighborhood, circle marketing, which includes sending mailers to the neighboring homes, agent-to-agent marketing, and even calling the neighbors. So finding an agent that will invest in your biggest investment and will actually put in the work is key. You also want to make sure that your agent is in constant communication with you. In my listing strategy, my seller clients receive a listing report at least once a week, and almost every day I give them an update either through a phone call or by text. A lot of agents out there come to the home, take photos, put a sign in the front yard, stick it in MLS, and just wait. And let me tell you, that is a failing strategy. You need to choose someone who will effectively market one of your biggest investments. Lastly, let's not forget about staging. Staging your home can make a world of difference in how it presents to potential buyers. Consider hiring a professional stager who can optimize your space, arrange furniture in an appealing way, and add a stylish decor to highlight your home's best features. If you're on a budget, you can also DIY stage by decluttering, rearranging furniture, and adding fresh flowers or plants to create a welcoming atmosphere. For my listing clients, I offer a complimentary staging service, and that is either to have a staging consultation or to have their home virtually staged. With my background in interior design, these offers set me apart from other agents. This adds to my value proposition. First option is for clients who prefer to keep their furniture in the house. In these cases, I offer a complimentary detailed staging consultation, which would normally cost someone between $150 to $300. During this consultation, we engaged in a detailed discussion, providing advice and reviewing what needs to be done to the property before listing it. Together, we walk through the home, meticulously identifying items that should be put away, areas that require decluttering, and additions that could enhance the presentation. Our goal is to ensure the home is showcased in the best possible light, guaranteeing the highest possible price. The second complimentary option I offer is tailored for sellers who won't have furniture in their house. And in this scenario, I take care of virtually staging the property, a service that typically cost between $100 to $300 if hired separately. Virtually staging allows you to present a property as it could be, which helps potential buyers emotionally connect to the home. Regardless of the chosen option, these staging services are an integral part of my value proposition. I am genuinely committed to assisting sellers in achieving their objectives and providing them with exceptional support throughout the selling process. Before we go on to the one thing that will net you the most return, I'd like to ask you for a favor. If you find this video useful at all, please hit that like button and subscribe to this channel. It helps me know what kind of videos to make more of, and with YouTube's algorithm to reach my goal, which is educating more home sellers. Finally, I promise to share the one thing that brings the most return when selling your home, and that is paint. I've seen many homes where people chose to paint or not to paint, and it makes a huge difference. Remove wallpaper, get rid of that popcorn ceiling, and choose a neutral color scheme. Avoid painting each room a different color, as it can overwhelm potential buyers. Painting your home in a neutral color will be your greatest return on investment. Remember, selling a home is not just about the physical aspects. It's also about creating an emotional connection with the potential buyers. So think about the story you want to tell about your home, highlight its unique features, and create a welcoming ambiance that makes buyers fall in love. And there you have it, my friends. Easy steps to make your home shine and attract those eager buyers. By following these tips, you'll be well on your way to a successful sale. Good luck with your home selling journey, and may the offers pour in.